गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ आवर न्यू लेक्चर रिगार्डिंग द कलेक्शन एंड कन्वेंस ऑफ सिस्टम्स ऑफ सैनिटेशन। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्मिनोलॉजीज एंड इन द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ एनवायरमेंटल इंजीनियरिंग टू एंड सम इम्पॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशंस रिलेटेड टू एनवायरमेंटल इंजीनियरिंग इन टू। बट नाउ वी आर प्रोसीडिंग टू द यूनिट नंबर वन and first topic is that the how the waste water or the sewage is collected and how the systems of conveyance of sanitations are involved in the sewerage system. So first of all you have to understand that that for the system of collection of conveyance of sanitation for the disposal of waste products of towns, two water works or two works are required, that is the collection works and the disposal work. The disposal work mainly consists of the treatment works, which are essential to treat the wastewater and dispose it off in such a way that it may not cause any harm to the health of the public nor pollute the nearby water sources. Also, the collection works are the works which are done to collect the waste products which is generated from the various sources. In olden days it was done by the conservancy method, but in modern days in advanced cities it is done by the water carrier system. So in this lecture we are much focused on the what are the various collection methodologies and collection works involves in the environment wastewater or the waste related to the sanitation work. So we are proceeding to the methods of collection. That is, there are broadly the sanitation of a town or city is broadly done by the two methods, that is first conservancy system and second water carrier system. Okay, so what are the difference between them? It is the conservancy system, that is this system is also called as the dry system and generally it is adopted in the rural areas. So it is one of the patterns which is shown in the figure. So they say the how the conservancy systems are adopted. So first of all we will see the theory of it, that is the conservancy system. Sometimes as I said earlier that this system is also called as the dry system. This system is in practice from very ancient times. Actually it is out of date system even though it is prevailing in small towns. Okay, but small towns, villages and undeveloped portions of the large cities, the various types of refuse, that is waste and storm waters, are collected, conveyed and disposed of separately by different methods in this system. Therefore it is called as the conservancy system. So first of all we have to understand that it is a dry system and it is done in the practice from the very ancient time, and also it is prevailing in the small towns, that is in the rural areas, villages and some undeveloped portions of the large cities, that is the slum areas of the large cities. So in this system the waste or the refuse and the storm waters are collected, conveyed and disposed of separately by different methods in this system, and therefore it is also called as the conservancy system. So majorly it is in this system the manpower are employed for the disposal of the waste or the proper sanitation system. So what are the various types of waste involved in it? That is first, that is garbage or dry refuse of a town is collected in dustbins placed along the roads and streets, from where it is conveyed by trucks or covered carts once or twice in a day to the point of discharge. So this is the first method, that is the collection of the solid waste or the garbage of a town is collected in dustbins placed along the roads or the streets, from where it is collected by the trucks or covered once or twice in a day at up to the point of the disposal. So who will collect or who will convey it by through the trucks? Obviously it is worked by the man force or human agencies. All the non-combustible portions, that is those portions that which can't burn easily, of the garbage such as sand, dust, clay, ashes, etc., are used for the filling the low level areas to reclaim that land for further development of the town. And the combustible portion of the garbage such as dry leaves, waste paper, broken furniture, etc., are burned. The decaying fruit, that the fruit and vegetables, grass and other things are first dried and then disposed of by burning on in the manufacturing of the manure. So this is the methodology or process involved in the conservancy system, and hence the non-combustible portions or the waste and combustible waste and the decaying fruit and vegetables are properly disposed of using various methodologies and in their involvement in the waste. Okay, moving forward to it, also the major problem comes here that the human excreta or the night soil is collected separately in privies, that is, or and that is in the latrines or conservancy latrines. That is the human excreta or night soil, generally we will call it as that night soil, is collected separately in the privies or conservancy latrines. The liquid and the semi-liquid waste are collected in separate drains of the same latrine from where they are removed through the human agencies. Means the liquid and the semi-liquid waste are then separately collect from the drains of the same latrine from where they are removed through the human agencies. The night soil is taken outside to the town in closed drain, closed animal drawn carts, trucks or tanks mounted on the trailers, and the night soil is buried in the trenches. In conservancy system, the sludge and the storm waters are also carried out separately in closed or open drains up to the point of disposal, where they are allowed to mix with stream, rivers or sea without any treatment. So major disadvantage of the system is comes here that the human excreta or night soil is carried by the human agency, and it is carried from each house of the town or the locality, and it is taken outside the town in a closed manner or sometimes in the open trailers, and then the whole the area become dirtied or become equipped with the foul smell, and hence it causes very nuisance in the society. If the human agency or the human manpower is absent at the allotted day and time, the pans which have collected the liquid and semi-liquid waste will get filled, and hence for the further use of that conservation landscape becomes impossible, because the waste carrying capacity of that pans become full, and hence it carries problems and it carries nuisance, because these type of waste will spill over that containers and hence create nuisance and the nearby area. So this is the main drawback of the conservancy system. Okay, sometimes the sludge and the storm waters are also carried out separately in the closed or open drains up to the point of disposal, and if where they are allowed to mix with stream, rivers or sea without any treatment. Okay, if in the especially in the rainy areas, in rainy season, when the flow in the open drains or closed drains become full, and the drain pipe are going full at the full velocity, the waste become overflow and it also run on the road surface, and hence it has become very creating any nuisance for the commuters which is moving at that road surface. So moving ahead further, so what are the merits and demerits of the conservancy system? The following order, first we will see the merits of the conservancy system, that is, it is cheaper in initial cost because storm water can pass in open drains and conservancy latrines are much economical. Similarly, the quantity of sewage reaching at the treatment plant before disposal is low, means the sewage reaching the treatment plant before the disposal point is become very low for the obviously for the become losses while the uses by the human agency. As the storm water goes in open drains, the sewer section will be small and will run full for the major portion of the year, due to which there will be no silting and depositing in the sewer lines, and because it is one of the major merit of the conservancy system that when the sewer section go through this storm water section and will with full run for major section of the year, due to which there will be no sections, means जब ड्रेन में फुल फ्लो से वाटर स्टॉर्म वाटर जब पास होगा तो वहाँ पे कोई भी सिल्टिंग या फिर कोई भी डिपॉजिट नहीं रहेगा और उसके वजह से वो सीवर अपने आप क्लीन होती जाएगी. इन फ्लड्स इफ द वाटर लेवल और रिवर राइजेस एट द आउटफॉल इट विल नॉट बी कॉस्टली टू द पम्प द सीवेज फॉर द डिस्पोजल एंड हेंस द इट विल रिड्यूस द कॉस्ट फॉर द पम्पिंग और द पम्पिंग रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर द डिस्पोजल for the sewage disposal in the flood or the in the rainy seasons, because the water level or water rises at the outfall. Similarly, we are going for the demerits. It is possible that storm water may go in sewer causing heavy load on treatment plant, therefore it is to be watched. Means the storm water which we have studied in the previous section, that it is merely very less turbid or less impure in nature, and it may go in sewer causing heavy load on the treatment plant, therefore it is to be watched. Means we limit the quantity of the total wastewater. In the crowded lanes, it is very difficult to lay two sewers or construct roadside drains causing great inconvenience to the traffic, because in the crowded areas or crowded lanes it will become very difficult for the to lay the two sewer lines along the parallel of the road surface or to construct roadside drains causing great inconvenience to the traffic. Buildings cannot be designed as compact unit because latrines are to be designed away from the living room due to the foul smell, which are also inconvenient. Means the compact design is impossible, and because the latrines are or the bathrooms are to be designed away from the living areas due to the foul smell, or which are also causing very inconvenient for the users. In the presence of the conservancy system, the aesthetic appearance of a city cannot be increased. Means the aesthetic appearance of the city in the presence of the conservancy system cannot be increased due to the continuous movement of the sewage, continuous foul smells of the night soil or the human excreta. Therefore, the aesthetic appearance of the city cannot be improved. Decomposition of sewage causes insanitary conditions which are dangerous to the public health, and it causes very dangerous conditions due to the insanitary conditions, because the decomposition of sewage causes many diseases which further reacts and which causes insanitary conditions. Means it may create many type of diseases and which are dangerous to the public health. This system completely depends on the mercy of the sweepers. Means this is the systems completely depends on the mercy of the sweepers or the human agency. If the human agency is absent on the particular day, the it will uh, the city will become the heaps of the waste or of the dry waste and wet waste, and in the there will be the monopoly of the sweepers that they will charge at a particular cost for the clearance of waste or for the removal of waste, and hence this system completely depends on the mercy of the sweepers. So moving ahead, and we will see the next type, that is the water carriage system, which is nowadays prevailing in our city, and this is an improved version of the waste collection of the sanitation. So with the development and the advantages of the cities, urgent need was felt to replace conservancy system with some more improved types of systems in which human agencies should not be used for the collection and conveyance of the sewage. Okay, after a large number of trials, it was found that water is the only cheapest substance which can be easily used for collection and conveyance of sewage. Therefore, it is also called as water carriage system. With the development, means you have to understand that with the development and the advantages of the cities, it was an urgent need that was felt to replace the conservancy system with some more improved types of system in which the human agency should not be used for the collection and conveyance of the system. Means we have to reduce the monopoly of the sweepers or their mercy of the sweepers for the collection and conveyance of the systems of sanitation. And after a large number of trials, it was found that the water is the only cheapest substance and which is can be easily used and easily available thing used for the collection and conveyance of the sewage. Therefore, it is called as the water carriage system. Okay, moving ahead. In this system, the excremental matter are mixed up in large quantity of water and are disposed of after necessary treatment in the satisfactory manner. Means in the word means here, excremental means the word is comes up from the excreta. Okay, so in this system, the excremental matters means the human waste or the urine are mixed up in a large quantity of water. After the use of the water closet, we generally use to flush the waste, and which are mixed up in the large quantity of water and are disposed of after necessary treatment, and which are disposed of after necessary treatment, and this treatment is generally given at the sewage treatment plant in a satisfactory manner. Means the treated water which can be disposed of in many way, either in a river body or in a land, which cannot affect the human agency or the subsoil or the or water table, and hence this system this system can be used after treatment in a satisfactory manner. Okay, so this is the system which is shown in the figure, that it can be possible in a compact manner, that it is a basement, first floor, second floor, toilets are provided over one each floor, and these toilets are attached to the compact designs of the pipeline, and these pipelines attached to the storm water or storms or sanitary sewer, and the storm water which is generally collected from the roof water or from the courtyard is further collected from the catch basins with the trap, and it is collected again further from the storm water. Means here we can conclude that the storm water and the sanitary sewage both can be replaced or both can be disposed or both can be collected easily in the water carriage system. So, what are the merits and demerits of the water carriage system? First merit, that it is hygienic method, because all the excremental matters are collected and conveyed by water only, and no human agency is employed for it. First point. ठीक है, देर इज नो न्यूसेंस इन द स्ट्रीट ऑफ द टाउन ड्यू टू ऑफेंसिव मैटर्स बिकॉज ऑल द सीवेज गोज इन क्लोज सीवर अंडर द ग्राउंड, द रिस्क ऑफ एपिडेमिक इज ऑल्सो रिड्यूस. ठीक है, एज ओनली वन सीवर इज लेड देयर फॉर इट ऑक्यूपाइज लेस स्पेस इन द क्राउडेड लेन्स. ठीक है, मीन्स एट दिस पॉइंट वी हैव डिस्कस दैट इन द क्राउडेड लेन इन कंजर्वेंसी सिस्टम वी हैव टू प्रोवाइड टू ड्रेन्स, टू ओपन ड्रेन्स एट ईच रोड सो दैट इट कैरीज द वेस्ट फ्रॉम ईच हाउसेस एंड दैट वेस्ट विल ट्रेवल टू द डिस्पोजल साइट. बट एज ओनली वन सीवर इज लेड देयरफॉर इट ऑक्यूपाइज लेस स्पेस इन द क्राउडेड लेन ड्यू टू मोर क्वांटिटी ऑफ सीवेज, सेल्फ क्लींजिंग वेलोसिटी ऑफ द पाइप और द सीवर कैन बी ऑब्टेन इवन एट लेस ग्रेडियंट्स मीन्स लेस स्लोप्स एंड बिल्डिंग्स कैन बी डिजाइन एज कॉम्पैक्ट यूनिट, द लैंड रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द डिस्पोजल वर्क इज लेस एज कंपेयर्ड विद द कंजर्वेंसी सिस्टम्स इन मोर एरिया इज रिक्वायर्ड, द यूजुअल वाटर सप्लाई इज sufficient and no additional water is required in water carriage system. This system does not depend on the manual labors and sewage after proper treatment can be used for various purposes. So these are the 10 basic merits, means it is a hygienic method because all the excremental matter are collected and conveyed by the water and no human agency employed. It will not create any nuisance in the street. Therefore, the risk of epidemic is reduced. Only one sewer is laid due to more quantity of sewage. Automatically, the self-cleansing velocity of the sewer can be obtained. Building can be designed as compact unit. No land required for the disposal of work is less as compared with the conservation system. The usual water supply is sufficient and no additional water is required in the water carry system. This system does not depend on any manual labors and sewage after proper treatment can be used for various purposes. And so if something carries merits, so some are demerits are also associated with it. So we have to see the demerits of the water carriage system also. The following are the demerits of the water carriage system. This system is very costly in initial cost, means the initial setup cost is very high, means we have to set the total pipeline system, the water closet, traps, flushing unit, etc. Means therefore the first initial cost is very low. But in the conservancy system it does not require any such type of cost because it will not require any type of water pipeline system, water closet, etc. The maintenance of this unit is also very costly because if the sanitary unit, it requires the taps, it requires the flushing unit, and if the maintenance or if some thing it become repairable, we have to repair or we have to replace with the new one, and it is generally very costly. The sanitary item is generally very costly, and hence the maintenance of the system is also costly. During monsoon, large volume of sewage is to be treated, whereas very, very small volume is to be treated in the remaining period of the year. Means during the monsoon, large volume of sewage is to be treated, whereas very small volume is to be treated in the remaining period of the year, because in the monsoon season, the storm water is also get attached or get equipped with the sewage, and hence the quantity of sewage becomes increased, and hence the load on the sewage treatment plant is increases. Whereas in other than the rainy season, very small volume is to be treated in the remaining period of the year. So these are the demerits of the water carriage system. So this is all about the collection and conveyance of system of sanitation. Hope you have understand the concept regarding to it. Means broadly you have to understand that there are two systems, that is conservancy system and water carriage system. I am summarizing the whole lecture. First, in conservation system, the waste which is either solid waste or the excremental matter waste is collected by the human agencies, and it is collected by human agency, and it carries the waste by in their cart and dispose of in the nearby town. And generally, conservation system is practiced in the rural areas or in the slum areas, which is undeveloped areas of the large cities. And hence, it requires the mercy of the sweepers if the human manpower is absent at the particular time, and the collection of the waste will become impossible, and hence it creates nuisance to the society and to the town. But as the demerits are associated with the conservation system, we have moved to the water carriage system, and in this system it's a compact design is allowed, and hence only water is used to mix the sewage, that is the excremental matter, and water after many trial water is used as a conclusive material, so that it is very cheap in nature and easily available to all the commuters or the users, and therefore it becomes very hygienic method, and all the excremental matters are collected and conveyed by the water only, and no human agency is employed for it, and there is no nuisance in the street or the of the town due to offensive matters, because all the sewage goes in the closed sewers and under the ground. The risk of epidemic is reduced as only one sewer is laid, therefore it occupies less space in crowded lane. Due to more quantity of sewage, self-cleansing velocities also occur, and at less gradients, compact unit is allowed, and the land required for the disposal is less as compared to the conservation system. The usual water supply is sufficient, and no additional required water is in the water carriage system, and thus the system is not depend on the manual labors, and sewage after proper treatment can be used for the various purposes. Hope you have understood the concept of all of today's lecture. And if you have any doubt related to it, please mention in the comment box of, given here. So I'm signing off. Okay, thank you.